got him! He got the ball!
Executed by 12 John Brown, champion Toothpicks of next game!
Look at that!
30 years of Monster Jam!
That was close! Oh! Oh, that was awesome! Scoops is back! That was awesome. That was cool. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Now let's get the World Finals started, everyone. Time for a test pass to see if it works.
Yeah. We will now rerun the Megalodon Bad Company matchup at the end of the round. Raptor on the blue lane. So this is something that if you look in the future, it's starting to get a little choppy.
Second.
from. We've got one matchup to decide our final four of the semifinals.
Thank you. I pick one. I picked Brandon to win, and he won. Oh, really? Inclement weather, really? I had no idea. Brandon!
Yeah! Over here, man! Wow! Yeah!
Oh, man.
Are you going to do a mix?
Oh, man. Well, that was cool.
Out on the track has that tough job.
That's a good shot.
Setting the bar exactly is how high will it be.
Oh, yeah.
That is up to you and our expert judges. So if you're here at the Camping World Stadium, make sure you have a say in history by being at judgeszone.com. You're going to need to enter in a code ORL. Then everybody here is big Monster Jam fans, so I know you know what to do. What will Brandon Vincent score? It's going to be up to you. We really set the bar. We're about to find out, and this will take off the entire competition.
Scores are locked in, and there you see it on the board, a 6.119. That combines the average of all of your individual scores and our experts.
Oh, God.
Replay brought to you by the original Super Glue, starting off his one into a nose really. Got great control, trying to go up the pod in a moonwalk. Don't forget, Monster Jam fans, you will have 30 seconds to lock in those scores at judgeszone.com. There he is out of his truck waiting for his scores by you, the fans. He has won 23 competitions in the Skills Challenge this season.
I hope you locked in those scores because time is up and they are close. 6.119 is your score to beat with Gravedigger. Let's check out the score for El Toro Loco. It's... We will have a 6.683. Remember, up next, the only consecutive four-time triple threat series in Monster Jam history.
Thank you.
That was really good. He lost it twice, and then kind of cheated to get it back. But that was still awesome. That was
30
really
seconds are
attempt.
Gone. The scores are locked in. There you see the score of El Toro Loco.
That'll get the lead.
6.683. The score for Grave Digger is...
Fans are going to be a 9.5.
We have a new lead of 8.232. Coming up next from Kildare, North Carolina, one of the best in the world.
Tonight in Olymp Camping World Stadium. He's trying to earn that Wins His Repertoire for the Skills Challenge. Will he get it? We're going to find out that score right now.
I like the drone cam.
We find out that score first. Of course, the score to be 8.232 with Tyler Meninga. The score for Ryan Anderson is...
Wow.
Champion, Top Max D.
Woohoo! Yeah.
boys, it is up to you, Monster Jam fans. Score Tom Mantis.
First shit of the world finals comes from that.
Giving up maximum moon flip.
Oh,
definitely turning up the heat in the competition for the great clips.
That better be the winner.
And we've
everyone
got the
telling me, oh no, Tom's not going to win again.
All I can say
is
wow.
Be better,
I hope you lock those
that.
Scores in. 30 seconds are gone. Score to beat 8.232. And the score for Max D is.
Better be in nines.
Yeah! Yeah!
judgeszone.com. That was Tristan England coming in from Paris, Texas. Take a look at the replay of the glue to the action up on the video board. Tristan comes from the Arena Championship Series West and has 15 great clips, two wheel skills wins this season. This is his fourth World Finals appearance. And last night in racing, he won the bronze medal. Scoring is now locked in.
That's right, 30 seconds are gone. Let's see what you came up with for Earthshaker. And the rising star of the year from Onatiska, Illinois, Camden Murphy, you Monster Jam fans have a say in history here today. We've got just a few seconds to get those scores locked in at judgeszone.com. 30 seconds are gone. Let's see what you came up with. A 4-2 and great clip. Two wheel skills challenge. Two-time world final champion, Tom Ledoux, Blue Thunder.
in the scores, Monster Jam fans at judgeszone.com.
That's awesome.
Tom LeDuc finishing his skills run with a
bicycle
on the side on two wheels. Let them know what you think right now at judgeszone.com. He is a two-time World Finals champion with wins in racing and in freestyle. But this is his first appearance in that Blue Thunder truck. Let him know what you think about it. Just a few seconds left to lock in those scores right now. Scores are now locked in.
That means 30 seconds are gone. Let's see what you came up with for Todd LeDuc and Blue Thunder, 6.321. That is not nearly enough to take over that top spot. And that means that your winner here today of the Great Clips 2-Wheel Skills Challenge is none other than Todd.
Moonwalk, but we had no idea. How did you come up with that elevated move here for World Finals competition?
Oh no!
Do it.
That was huge.
And here in the high jump competition, you don't really have to land on all 4 feet and 18 tires to qualify for a score.
Just well, good thing he uses other trucks for that.
At this point, I know all drivers, they want to land on the wheels. They don't want to land on the motor.
What's the height?
But Jim Glover, 30 years ago, you can get a wild back here out of these Monster Jam fans.
Yeah, they did last time.
Jim Glover!
Camera photo stuff. What was the height? Show the height.
Let's take a look at the height, and there you see it, 33.144 feet. And of course, it's Chad Ledoux, Blue Thunder.
Yeah!
Mark has a tune-up on that one. He grabs
well, that. Okay, that's probably going to get the lead now. Let's see.
To be able to shoot him in the air.
Oh, that was high up.
Which holds the two tires together, it blew apart. But the full commitment to try and get as high as she possibly could was there for her.
And it's great elevation, 33.555, but it will not be enough. That is second place. That means regardless of what happens, we're going to have a new world champion here today.
Absolutely.
Take over second place, but you are right, Gordon.
ignition problems. I mean, something as simple as like a spark plug broke or a possible spark plug close. Wires having a burn mark on it. That can cause it to break up.
Next, the 2022 Stadium Championship Series Yellow Champion, Ryan Anderson, son of a digger, powered by Boomikin. I want to be able to look at this because all three of these look really close.
Going high. Great checking, it was the thing to do. Great to your truck and head outside, right?
see this mustache, this ain't for me. 40 years of Gravedigger, 40 years of Dennis Anderson, and we are not even close to being done yet, baby!
So Ryan, what more? You picked up your third world championship. And so what does that mean to add that to the stockpile as you catch up to your dad and your brother?
Man, no doubt it's awesome. Every world championship is a big deal. But I'm keeping my head on my shoulders right now. And I remember my last name, Anderson. And you know what we created. You know what we came here for. You know why. We brought more Gravediggers here than we've ever brought anywhere else in the world. Monster Jam Freestyle!
Andy Murphy is a big And kick it off, really did he ever? Let's see what you came up with. A 7.373.
A good place
a lot of symmetry and almost very
oh, yeah.
The 2022 I'm excited for this. Rookie
first ever stadium run.
Weston Anderson.
And it is up right now. You may have scored
the judges have a 7 flat for a total of 7.176.
And best believe she's gunning for that top last time. Tonight in Orlando. Scores are locked in.
Let's see what you came up with for Brianna Mahan. 6.320 for the total score. You can see the judges were a little bit. Coming up next, here at BKT Freestyle and Fat Man, Jamie Garner, over the ball.
Thank you.
on.
Keep up that energy for Jamie Gardner in Overboard. What an epic freestyle run, Orlando. They are showing you the best of the world. This stadium is electric, but
that was good.
You've got your hands.
We left almost 40 seconds on the clock, and that was still really
Jamie
good.
Jamie Gardner about to receive a score for a radical freestyle run. Absolutely incredible. Jamie Gardner, Overboard, part of the Stadium Championship Series right here in your 2022 season. Wow, what an incredible run from him. Just to let you know, his truck sits a couple inches wider, so he loves freestyle, as we get set to see those scores coming up on the video board.
You'll see the score to beat. Dragon open things up, 7.373. The score for Overboard is...
7.2.
You gotta feel some Stadium Championship Series red pride.
Of course I do.
Looking for a second world
replay video, but Bryce Kenny holds the record for the fastest Monster Jam truck in the world, and he definitely uses that speed out on the track. Also, definitely giving us that wow factor that we all love in freestyle. I know that we are hoping they can get it back on 4BKC tires, but it is sometimes just as exciting to watch them not be able to flip it back over. But we have the official scores locked in.
turn our attention over to the BKT Freestyle score to beat 7.473 with Overboard. The score for Greek Clips Mohawk Warrior is... it will not quite be enough, 6.727. That means...
Holly Pockin, Monster Mod!
Build them tougher!
Give it up for Tristan England, driving Earthshaker. Tristan England did fill those first 30 seconds, so he is eligible for a score. This means that Monster Jam fans, if we've got Earthshaker fans in the house tonight, you have the opportunity to score at judgezone.com right now. As long as those drivers fill that 30 seconds and deliver a big enough wow factor, they too have a chance at walking away with that title. Well, we are awaiting your fan scores right now. Let's take a look at the video board as we see the Bootsy Action replay. Your score is locked in. It is a 4.437. This is John Gordon.
How'd you know that?
Bad Company.
Yeah.
backflip. So
that was good. That's really good. Third.
That we want you to take into consideration when scoring at judgeszone.com. We mean it, Monster Jam fans. When we say you have a chance at making history.
I'm not talking to you.
Turn our attention over to the score to beat. It's been hanging on for a while. 8.343 with Monster Mutt, and the score for Zombie is.
Once again, this is the 40th anniversary of Gravedigger. A cool fact about Kristen Anderson, she is the first female competitor of Monster Jam to win an overall event series championship. Lock in those scores right now at judgeszone.com. A great run. Scores are locked in.
Let's see what you came up with for Kristen Anderson and Gravedigger. 6.515, that will not be enough. It's Caleb Lund, Soldier Fortune!
Oh! Stock, you didn't do that. Oh, that was insane.
Lock in the scores right now.
That was one of the best bicycle moonwalks ever. He's been trying that all year, and he finally gets up.
Giving you a backflip.
And he walked like halfway up the center ramp. That was awesome.
Into a moonwalk. Woo! Lock in the scores. I hear you out there in the stands. Make sure you are keeping that same energy at JetJetZone.com. This is Mark List's first appearance at Monster Jam World Finals. Let them know what you think, because guess what? Really right now, we're about to find out his score. Yeah.
Turn our attention to that score. To beat him. He's been hanging on for a long time. 8.343 with Monster Mott. And the score for El Toro Loco is
7.5 probably.
Champion two times. He proved exactly why he is our 2022 Extreme Air winner, but it all comes to this point where you are at judgeszone.com scoring for that freestyle run we just saw here. Only a few seconds left to get those scores officially locked in for Jim Kohler in Avenger. Incredible Big Air. Let's take a look at the video board. The score
is in Vegas right now, but what a way for Jim to celebrate 25 years of Avenger. We had to do something special for him. No fountain, we'll bring a fountain to him.
Listen, I was there in Vegas when he took his swim, and here we are in Orlando. I know he has been sweating out there on the track, and he's going to get ready to take that plunge. Let's make some noise for Jim Kohler.
Of the legendary Avenger.
And this is Ed Anderson, Grave Digger.
score, the total will not nearly be enough for that top spot. While we have the opportunity, let's check in.
Champion from Mordeaux, South Dakota, Cole Bedard, the Black Pearl. Finally knocked that leading score out of first place for Charlie Paulson in Monster Mutt. It is up to you, Monster Mutt. Make sure you are at judgeszone.com. I just got word those scores are locked in.
I think as a run exactly so far, that was
Keen said,
the best
I hope those scores are locked in because time is up. There's your score to beat, which continues to belong to Charlie Popkin and Monster Mutt. 8.343. The score for the Black Pearl is...
No, don't like that.
7.967, that will still not be enough.
OTA, Lucas Stegerizer. I need everybody at that Camping World Stadium to get those truckers in the zone.
Oh my God. That's so sad. The horn doesn't work anymore.
Hit the scores and
still going.
Don't forget, you have 30 seconds.
Here comes Scoops over the rest of the home. My voice is gone. It's getting worse. Said that at least 10 times in the video so far.
Be a part of history. Now, don't miss out on the action. You control the scores of each competitor. Just a few seconds left to lock in those scores.
She almost had that, dude. That was sick.
Turn our attention up to the video board and see what you came up with for Cynthia Gauthier and Lucas Stabilizer here in the freestyle competition. 6.004. A great score, but that is not nearly enough to take over that top spot of the scream. It's Tori Rubble, Megalodon.
Short of a score.
Give it up for Tori Rubble in Megalodon.
Ladies and gentlemen, he did not fill the 30 seconds necessary to get a score over at judgeszone.com. An unfortunate turn of events for Tori Rubble and for Megalodon, but on hand, as one of our expert judges here today, we have the reigning Freestyle World Finals champion, Lindsey Reed, and she's standing by with Kay Young.
Listen, oh. Champion, this is Todd LeDoux, Blue Thunder.
Thank you.
2014. And best believe, he's trying to get another win tonight here in Orlando. Don't forget about that backflip and that save off the backflip. There it is up there on the video board.
You can win
by logging in those scores at judgeszone.com. Ladies and gentlemen, you only have a few seconds left.
Now, right on cue.
Oh, locked in.
Right on cue, scores are locked. Score to be 8.343. Still with Monster Lock, the score for Blue Thunder is...
That'll be like 8.6.
Over-rotation on that backflip, but still, he's able to deliver that wow factor, which could be enough. That means now you need to get your scores locked in at judgeszone.com. Your scores are in. As we see, he will receive a 7.052.
Tyler!
Rosen on the video board. Tyler Menega has a full freestyle run to play with. He can get refired. He has his
Thank you.
message here, fans, your last chance of the night to lock in those scores at JudgesZone.com. This is Monster Jam.
I don't know, Ryan had a lot of air and momentum, but Tom had
that replay is up on the video board by that action brought to you by Son of a Digger. Now, he is the first competitor of the night to do the backflip off of the pod. Let him know what you think about it right now. JudgesZone.com. Just a few seconds left.
I can see Ryan win.
Scores are locked in.
Score to be Max D. 8.615. This is for the Freestyle World Finals Championship. The score for Ryan Anderson is...
Yeah!
Try to play spoiler, and what does he do? He adds not one, but two trophies to the Tom Mantz trophy case.
The most decorated Monster Jam driver in history. Congratulations to Tom Mantz and Maxi. He's been throwing down these scores all season long on Singing Championship Series Red. He was so focused on coming in to World Finals 21 this weekend. And it really showed on that run.
It was absolutely incredible. And you know what? The way that it ended, I'm happy that it came down to three former champions. And now, handing in his trophy and talking to the 14-time champion, Tom Mantz.
Supposed to go before him. He backed out. He let me go. I got in. I went before him. We got it done. By then, I was mad. You know, when I get mad, I'm just like, they told me, it's hit. The rear steering's working fine. We don't know how long. I'll tell you guys, it lasted all night long. So the more we did, the crazier it got. Wow. The wilder the run. I know if I could put down a good run, it'd have Ryan thinking. He's an awesome competitor. He's always tough to beat. All these drivers are fantastic.
Wow.
But you know what? This was my weekend. Sorry, Dennis. I appreciate your 30 years of service. But man, I've had a great time at your celebration party.
Yes! Fireworks. Oh my God.
In the sporting world, there has never been a dynasty that's lasted as long as Gray Digger's reign over Monster Jam. When the red headlights come on, when Gray Digger takes the track, you feel alive.
There's a chill in the air, and then people get electric. Man, there's nothing like it.
Recognizable brand because of the people behind it. You know you're going to see something spectacular.
Please welcome the icon, Gray Digger's Dennis Anderson.
I got to tell you guys, man, this whole thing for the last 40 years was never a plan. It just happened.
I think anybody that steps into a Gray Digger truck has a huge sense of pride in what that truck means to Monster Jam.
Every driver that steps into Gray Digger has told me that there is an expectation. organization that you have to bring it.
Not anybody can just step in and on the Great Digger team. They really look for that Great Digger style. And Brandon Minson really drive like Great Digger drivers.
We see aspects of Dennis and all of the kids. They're definitely carrying on the legacy.
I hope that Gravedigger is something that people can be fans of for generations upon generations.
I am so excited to keep this legacy of Gravedigger going. It's what I was born to do.
Gravedigger's been around for 40 years, and to see how it's affected other motorsports, none of us can be Dennis Anderson. We can all be a little bit of Gravedigger.
Come on, first, it's the OG Brandon, the crowd
Woohoo!